Section 15 of the Art of Cookery Made Plain and Easy by Hannah Glasse. This LibriVox recording is in the public domain. Chapter 5. To Dress Fish. As to boiled fish of all sorts, you have full directions in the Lent chapter. But here we can fry fish much better, because we have beef dripping or hog's lard. Observe always in the frying of any sort of fish, first, that you dry your fish very well in a clean cloth, then do your fish in this manner. Beat up the yolks of 2 or 3 eggs, according to your quantity of fish. Take a small pastry brush and put the egg on. Shake some crumbs of bread and flour mixed over the fish, and then fry it. Let your stew pan you fry them in be very nice and clean, and put in as much beef dripping or hog's lard as will almost cover your fish, and be sure it boils before you put in your fish. Let it fry quick, and let it be of a fine light brown, but not too dark a colour. Have your fish sliced ready, and if there is occasion, turn it. When it is enough, take it up, and lay a coarse cloth on a dish, on which lay your fish, to drain all the grease from it. If you fry parsley, do it quick, and take great care to whip it out of the pan as soon as it is crisp, or it will lose its fine colour. Take great care that your dripping be very nice and clean. You have directions in the 11th chapter how to make it fit for use, and have it always in readiness. Some love fish in batter, then you must beat an egg fine, and dip your fish in just as you are going to put it in the pan. Or as good a batter as any is a little ale and flour beat up, just as you are ready for it, and dip the fish to fry it. Lobster sauce. Take a fine hen lobster, take out all the spawn, and bruise it in a mortar very fine, with a little butter. Take all the meat out of the claws and tail, and cut it in small square pieces. Put the spawn and meat in a stew pan, with a spoonful of anchovy liquor, and one spoonful of ketchup, a blade of mace, a piece of a stick of horseradish, half a lemon, a gill of gravy, a little butter rolled in flour, just enough to thicken it. Put in half a pound of butter nicely melted. Boil it gently up for 6 or 7 minutes. Take out the horseradish, mace and lemon, and squeeze the juice of the lemon into the sauce. Just simmer it up, and then put it in your boats. Shrimp sauce. Take half a pint of shrimps, wash them very clean. Put them in a stew pan with a spoonful of fish liquor or anchovy liquor, a pound of butter melted thick. Boil it up for 5 minutes, and squeeze in half a lemon. Toss it up, and then put it in your cups or boats. To make oyster sauce for fish. Take a pint of large oysters, scald them, and then strain them through a sieve. Wash the oysters very clean in cold water, and take the beards off. Put them in a stew pan, pour the liquor over them, but be careful to pour the liquor gently out of the vessel you have strained it into, and you will leave all the sediment at the bottom, which you must be careful not to put into your stew pan. Then add a large spoonful of anchovy liquor, 2 blades of mace, half a lemon, some butter rolled in flour, enough to thicken it. Then put in half a pound of butter, boil it up till the butter is melted. Then take out the mace and lemon, squeeze the lemon juice into the sauce, give it a boil up, stir it all the time, and then put it into your boats or basins. Note well, you may put in a spoonful of ketchup or a spoonful of mountain wine. To make anchovy sauce. Take a pint of gravy, put in an anchovy, take a quarter of a pound of butter rolled in a little flour, and stir all together till it boils. You may add a little juice of lemon, ketchup, red wine, and walnut liquor, just as you please. Plain butter melted thick, with a spoonful of walnut pickle or ketchup, is a good sauce, or anchovy. In short, you may put as many things as you fancy into sauce. All other sauce for fish you have in the Lent chapter. To dress a brace of carp. Take a piece of butter and put into a stew pan. Melt it and put in a large spoonful of flour. Keep it stirring till it is smooth. Then put in a pint of gravy and a pint of red port or claret, a little horseradish scraped, 8 cloves, 4 blades of mace, and a dozen corns of allspice. Tie them in a little linen rag, a bundle of sweet herbs, 1/2 lemon, 3 anchovies, a little onion chopped very fine. Season with pepper, salt, and cayenne pepper to your liking. Stew it for 1/2 hour, then strain it through a sieve into the pan you intend to put your fish in. Let your carp be well cleaned and scaled, then put the fish in with the sauce, and stew them very gently for 1/2 hour. Then turn them and stew them 15 minutes longer. Put in along with your fish some truffles and morels scalded, some pickled mushrooms, an artichoke bottom, and about a dozen large oysters. Squeeze the juice of 1/2 lemon in, stew it 5 minutes. Then put your carp in your dish and pour all the sauce over. Garnish with fried sippets and the roe of the fish, done thus. Beat the roe up well with the yolks of 2 eggs, a little flour, a little lemon peel chopped fine, some pepper, salt, and a little anchovy liquor. Have ready a pan of beef dripping boiling. Drop the roe in to be about as big as a crown piece. Fry it of a light brown, and put it round the dish with some oysters fried in batter and some scraped horseradish. Note well, stick your fried sippets in the fish. You may fry the carp first, if you please, but the above is the most modern way. Or, if you are in a great hurry, while the sauce is making, you may boil the fish with spring water, 1/2 pint of vinegar, a little horseradish and bay leaf. Put your fish in the dish and pour the sauce over. To dress carp or bleu. Take a brace of carp alive and gut them, but not wash nor scale them. Tie them to a fish strainer and put them into a fish kettle and pour boiling vinegar over till they are blue. Or you may hold them down in a fish kettle with 2 forks, and another person pour the vinegar over them. Put in 1 quart of boiling water, 1 handful of salt, some horseradish cut in slices. Boil them gently 20 minutes. Put a fish plate in the dish, a napkin over that, and send them up hot. Garnish with horseradish. Boil 1/2 pint of cream and sweeten it with fine sugar for sauce in a boat or basin. End of section 15.